Warning, the following content may contain elements that are not suitable for some audiences. Viewer discretion is advised.
Welcome everybody back to another episode of American Truck Simulator. And today, it's going to be a little bit of an edit, a little bit of a non-edit video for you guys. So I pretty much just slept and I just woke up. I picked my cargo and we are going to go pick it up. So that is what we're going to do right now. So that is what we're doing. Right. So hope everybody's Tuesday is doing good. I know mine is. So that's always good. And I'm going to make this right here. And I'm gonna go before I get freight trained over here, because sometimes this can get really busy. Alright, we're gonna go. Oh, if I don't hit the rail, we should be good. So, and then we're gonna move over to the left lane. So, hope everybody's having a wonderful Tuesday. My Tuesday is going pretty well today, actually. I got off at my normal time at 3 o'clock today from work. And so that went, pretty well. And all that goody-goody-good stuff. I could make a left here if I pay attention. I was trying to fix my mic. Alright. So, work was good. It was just a little busy today, just due to the fact that they're tearing up our streets. Not our streets, but our sidewalks in a way. And, alright, keep it in between the lines. That will definitely help. I stalled the truck, shit. So, that's what they're doing. Now, I'm doing some testing with the volumes and everything. I raised the game volume, so I will see how that is. And actually, that's one way in. Alright. So, it cannot go in fourth, apparently, for some odd reason. This Kentworth cannot be in fourth. Alright, let's, so, as you can see, we are picking up, if I'm not mistaken, 17 tons? Yeah, 17 tons of cars. That will give us 1385. I would go with 24 tons. But I get paid more on that one. Nearly $8,000 more. So I will definitely take that as well. So what we're gonna do is pop it in the first L. I'm gonna see where our trailer is. Okay, it's all the way back there. So that is where we're gonna go, and I'm gonna go left as far as I can before I get there, and then swing right. So what I can do is use that opening in this garage to get me hitched up to this. Like I said in my last video, I'm gonna start to try to use my mirrors only to pick up these to pick up and drop off these just wanna see how well we did. Oh, we can do a lot more than that. No, actually we can do, so we were good. We were just off just a little bit. So we could have went back a little bit more, but we could have at the same time could have. That's not straight. See, and one way to tell where the kingpin is, the kingpin will always be dead center of the, see, I messed that up, of the trailer. Now, each trailer will determine on where the kingpin sits. It might be closer to the front. It might be closer to the back. And usually right about there is where the kingpin should be. So we're going to find that out now. Yep, and it was pretty much right there. So that's good. So we're going to put the parking brake on here. We're going to take a look at our cargo. So this is our cargo. Looks like some Dodge hatchbacks. Yeah, four of them. Four Dodge hatchbacks. That is awesome. And I'll just jump back in the car really quick. Everything looks secure. So now we're going to do is... That's not what I... F5? Really? Oh, I'm so used to playing with my... So we got... we're going... Barstow and Rail Export, which is going to be a disaster. Due to the fact that someone tells me I already know where we will be going. So, I'm not going to like it. Make sure my lights are on. Turn off our four ways, and we're going to get going here. Kind of got to swing wide so we don't hit that parked car there. All right, let's get going, boys and girls. So, anyway, so I hope everybody's Tuesday is doing good. That was my loan that just got done taken out. Anyway, so... Getting back to what I was saying, so I raised the game volume. I'm trying to figure it out on which way is best to go here, and so I'm doing a lot of playing around with my with the volume controls and all that, and you know, seeing what will work best, and that is what I'm trying to do. So if the volume sounds a little high, I apologize. And the reason why I also raised it a little bit was due to the fact that I bought an arm for my mic. So now I have it very close to my face. What I'm hoping is that will offset the game volume. So you can still hear the game volume normally. But, at least we have a double lane here we can use. Normally, and I don't have to raise it and lower it every single time I play a different game. And then still hear my voice normally with no issues. So, that's always a good thing. So, if the game volume is a little bit high, I do apologize. Like I said, I'm trying to figure everything out. So I can have a happy medium for everything, for my voice, for the game volume, and all that. I'm still trying to figure it out, and what I'm trying to figure out is what programs is picking up what, and that's my biggest thing is how is that program I'm using picking up the game volume? So that's what I have to figure out is it the microphone that's picking up the game volume? Or is it the program that's picking up the game volume through my sound card? So that is, you know, that is something I have to find out. And, alright, we're gonna put this in high. It's a gorgeous day here in Nevada. What I'm gonna do is do. Put in 5 high, low, put in 5 high now. What, we getting off? That just makes no sense to me, but okay. But anyway, so that's what I'm trying to figure it out. So, all in due time, will we get this, Will we get this bad boy up and running. I don't know, was he waiting for me? That's what I was trying to figure out. Like, was he waiting for me? So anyway, so once I can figure out what is capturing what. Then I'll be able to, then I'll be able to do things better, but, and this, well, the sound will come out better, you know, of course that will. 65 miles an hour, boys and girls, that is how I like it. So, like I said, I do apologize for the sound, for the loud sound. I really do. And we go straight on this beautiful highway. But yeah, so anyways, we're finally getting some nice weather at the location that I'm at, finally. And this is a construction zone. Might drop by and see, no, 30 miles an hour, so I'm assuming it's not. What? We're about to hit 55. We're at 55. But, oh, good Lord, I hit something I was not supposed to. I hit two buttons instead of one, and I went from sixth to third. Yeah, not good. So anyway, so that's what I'm trying to do, and hopefully, guys, I will have everything ready and set up for my live stream on Thursday. That is what I'm really hoping for. So everything will be all tight with that. Even though the speed limit says 80, I guess we can go 60. Why not? Blackjack Casino, everybody. Blackjack Casino. I'm going to do that to H. Step on the gas a little bit. Hit 60. There you go. So anyway, so I'm hoping on Thursday when I do my live stream, I'll be able, the volume will be perfect. So you'll be able to hear me, hear music playing, and all that good stuff. See, now that's what I like. It tells you way ahead of time, you know. We should be good right there, so we're gonna hit enter. Gross weight is 50,913. That is what I was trying to say. That is what I was trying to say, boys and girls. Alright, pop it in the second. Pop it in too high. Pop it in the 3L. Pop it in a 3 high. And then we're going to pop it in a 4 low. And then 4 high. Watch for traffic. And then pop it in a 5L. 5H. Turn off our signal. We're at 20,000 RPMs. Pop it in a 6L. And let this baby coast up this hill. So we're going down I-80 pretty much, if I'm not mistaken. I-80, if you guys don't know, it just means Interstate 80. That is what it means. But anyways, and Interstate means, I think if I'm not mistaken, it means what's like inside the state. So it's roads that go inside the state and just stay in the state. Now, of course, if you have, you know, roads that don't do that, you know, or if you have roads that continue, then it's a freeway. But the roads that stop at the border, if I'm not mistaken, is called interstates. So, but don't quote me on that. So anyway, so that's what I'm hoping for my for my sound, guys, is I'm trying to get better and better, and it's gonna take a long time because I don't have somebody else that can sit here and listen to my videos and go, no, that sounds awesome. Dropping down to 55 while we are speeding, so that means we just crossed into the border, which I wish they would add the border. Truckee, where are we going with Truckee? We don't go through Truckee, no, we go straight. So, anyways, I totally lost my train of thought now, but I'm hoping by my live stream everything will be perfect. So my voice is not too loud, the game volume is not too loud and all that. And oh, anyway, so that's what's taken so long, is I don't have anybody to listen to my videos. You know, I can't just live stream and go, okay, how is this? And you know, because then people think I'm live streaming, and then they're getting hours on my live stream. It's not even worth it. And then of course, then you gotta wait for them to respond, because you know there is a delay in what you're saying to by the time they get it. And then of course you're gonna have 50,000 people saying 100,000 different things. So you know you might have one person say, yeah, the volume is great, and then you're gonna have somebody else that says the volume is bad, which I just hit the mic stand. So you know, and of course every device you have is going to be different, you know, computers, laptops, speakers, phones. So you know, some person might be saying it's hard to hear me, but that might be because they might only have one speaker plugged into the PC, or one of the speakers might have blown, so they're only hearing out of one instead of two. So so I just think it's better for me just to sit down, do nothing crazy, but do like 2-3 minutes of recording of me talking and everything, and then review it, and then see how I am, and then adjust the volume from there. I think that would be the best way. But of course, that's just, you know, once again, that's how I'm doing it. So I mean, of course, if you have help, you know, of course, be my guest, do it from that help. But if you don't, you gotta do it this way. I gotta watch it. I am speeding just a little bit. Luckily, I wasn't doing too crazy. I was only doing 57 when I saw that cop, but you still don't want to take a chance. Welcome to Sacramento, guys. Welcome to Sacramento. 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 Oh, this is a... ginger snaps. I thought that said a right turn only. And then I look and there was a car right there. So I had to stop and slow down. That's what I get. That's what I get for a Klondike bar. Alright, 7L. So yeah, that's what's going on. Just an update, guys. And once again, this is just not even an update. It's more or less letting you know the end of my May schedule. Now, of course, we're not in April, so I have not done my May schedule, but I do know this: the last week of May, I won't be here doing any videos. Now, of course, I will try to do extra videos and post them before I go on my vacation. You know, you guys have a little something. But what was I throwing in reverse? You know, you guys will have a little something. I will be gone for a week. So I'll be leaving. I'm going to be on vacation from the 19th of May. all the way to, what is it, the 29th, I think? Yeah, I think it's the 29th. So I'm gonna be gone quite a bit at the end of May. And it's also my birthday at it's actually my birthday May 25th. So, I gonna spend time with my wife and all that. So, but I'll be going to Michigan. I'm gonna be up there and we'll go see my sister. Gonna stay around Door, Kalamazoo, all that area where I pretty much was. I wasn't born and raised, but I was there for pretty much my whole childhood, and I enjoyed it. I like it out there. I wish I can move out there. Hopefully one day I can. It looks like this bus is gonna be letting me go, so that is what I'm gonna do. So, but that's just me. So anyway, so it like I said, it's gonna be a week. So unfortunately, there won't be any videos that week. I probably will stop doing videos that. I'll safely assume my birthday's on that. It's on a Wednesday. We leave the 19th. I'm hoping either Thursday will be the last videos going out. For the week, for the next week. But the week before that, Friday will be my last video for my normal video scheduling. So just keep that in mind, guys. So it is what it is. We're getting there. Gonna go up to 30 miles an hour, 'cause that's the speed limit. So, anyways, and then of course, don't forget, in 2 weeks I will be doing my 1 month review of my PC. So keep an eye out on that. Like I said, I'm planning on doing that May, no, not May, April 9th. Either I'm gonna do it April 9th and it will be uploaded to you guys on the 10th, or I will do it on the 8th and then upload it to you guys on the 9th. But we'll see. I was wondering why those trucks just pretty much just blew my doors off, and I look and it's 65 miles an hour. That's once again, that's what happens when I'm not paying attention. 55 is the speed limit, guys. 55, stay alive. Just remember that, guys. So yeah, hope everybody's Tuesday is doing good. It's almost the weekend. Once again, guys, don't forget that my weekend is off this weekend. Of course, I won't be doing any videos, but I do have off this weekend, and I'm pretty much gonna be spending my time watching XAZ's live stream if he's still doing it. He's gonna be going to work, so that's something for him. And then of course, then you have, what's, and then I have my carpet cleaning, this Wednesday, not this Wednesday, this Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday. Kind of thinking it's either gonna be 1 or 2 days. It's either gonna be that Wednesday or that Friday, one of these 3 days, 'cause I might even do it during the day. I don't know. I might even do a live stream on Monday. I don't know yet, but I gotta look at my wife's schedule. But pretty much Sunday live stream. No, Sunday I work 9 to 3, which is 9 p.m. to 3 p. 3 a.m. Central Time. So time I get home is gonna be about 4 o'clock. Get up, I gotta go take my wife to work and then come home and sleep. And she probably doesn't get off until I think she closes that day. I gotta look. I think she closes, so I pretty much have the whole day. But either way, I'll have to go pick her up about, 5:30, 6 o'clock, and then come home, and then go back out to work at 9. But then I might do a live stream then, or I might even do two live streams. I might even do three. I don't know. It just might be something crazy. And then Tuesday, same thing, but that is a 9 to 6, so I won't get home until probably 6:30. Take my wife to work. No, that's Monday. Take my wife to work. No, I already said Monday. Did I say Monday? It sad how I don't quite remember. Thought I started off on no, yeah, that was Sunday, and then Monday. Yeah, that's when I yeah, so it is Tuesday, and then Tuesday I get off at 6, take my wife to work. I'll be fine. I'll pretty much have the whole car to I'll have the whole day to myself, and then Wednesday I'm off. Thursday I work 7 to 1. I'm running out of fuel. Yeah, that is not good. I guess we should go get some. That's the one thing I did forget, guys. Jesus Christ. I forget to go check my fuel. I thought I got everything checked, and fuel was just not on my mind today. So Wednesday I have off. Thursday I work 7 to 1, and then Friday I have off, and then that Saturday I work 7 to 4. So, it is what it is. And I think that was just a gas station. Let's see how many miles we have left. Oil temp fuel. So we have 159 miles. So we should be good. I'm gonna keep that on the miles so I know. But anyway, so it's like I said, it's gonna be sometime during that week. And the question is just when and what time. It's either gonna be Monday, Wednesday, or Friday. Because one of the people, one of the streamers that I watch streams Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. And he always does it. Is that a rainbow? No, I thought that was a rainbow. I was gonna say that would've been awesome if they added a rainbow. He streams on those days, and I could stream, but I would have to stream at, 12 o'clock, so he can jump in and see it for a little bit, and you guys can see it, and then I'll jump off to go see his stream at 3 o'clock. So it is what it is, unfortunately. So it's one of those days. Question is just when. And then, of course, my live stream for this week is this Thursday at 3 p.m. Central. We're gonna do a 3-hour stream. It's gonna go from 3 to 6, and we will have some fun with that. So come and join me, everybody. Come and join me on my live stream. So, fuel update. 18 gallons of fuel, 103 miles left to go. Doing 55 miles an hour, doing the old double nickel. Doing the old double nickel, and for some odd reason, something just looks a little blurry, and I don't know why. Graphics. It just looks blurry to me. 60, yes. Color correction, no. Grassy, why? Grassy should be on high. I don't know why it was not on high. Everything's on high. Oh, see, what is I'm trying. What is that? Guys, if you know what this NO traffic filtering means, let me know. Because I have no fucking idea. All right. Fifty-five, stay alive. Helped a little. Maybe because I'm so used to being so close to the screen. Now I'm further back from the screen than I'm used to. just due to the fact that I don't have a choice in the matter. Oh, that is not what I wanted, and I stalled it. I just saw the I saw my battery light go on. I forgot that this I'm surprised this doesn't. I thought this truck does, and it may, but because of the beta we're still in, it could be the reason why it's not showing up. Maybe there's a flaw. Oh, he's a suicide jockey. Don't want to come close to him. And it just doesn't show, but I saw it in the left, in my left gauge, the light, the red light showed up, which means it's just, it's like an engine stall. So it tells you that your engine is stalled. So, anyways, looking for a gas station. Was that just a gas station we just passed? I think that was. Still looking for a gas station. I just realized we're still looking for a gas station. It's not, it's drizzling. So we'll put the wipers on low here. And we're going to just do 20,000 RPMs, which is just about 28, 29 miles an hour. If I'm not mistaken, we have what? We still have 62 miles before empty. I'm trying to see what's on this map. Is that a gas station right there? That is a gas station. We're almost there. I don't think we're gonna make it. By the same time, we can always get this discoverable. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna get the discoverable. Not discoverable, but discover the road a little bit so we have more. I did as much as I can in there. I think I just got like two little sections I gotta complete for the Alright. Look at that, guys. Look at that. They actually now have... I said they were going to have a turning arrow. And they do. They do actually have a turning arrow for us. So, which is fantastic. Which will hopefully better the flow of traffic. Do they have one? I can't see. It'd be nice if they add a couple more. Another suicide jockey. That means the light is going to change if he stopped. Because that means he's probably... Yep, there it is. Alright. Don't hit me. Please, just for the love of God. Just don't hit me. Alright, and then we're going to make another left here. So you can go get some go-go juice, guys, so we don't run out. Because that would be bad. I guess that would be alright. Get out a little bit more. I think I turned a little too late. Yeah, I did. I turned a little too late. I'm still trying to get used to... See, now because we don't have such a long trailer, I can hopefully make this with no issues. Because we don't have such a long trailer like we did. Nope, we are good, yeah. Alright, we're gonna shut off the truck. Fill it up, see how much it's gonna cost us. Getting that fuel back up there. There you go, we're at half a tank. Half a tank is 270, so it's probably gonna be close to 5. Because 270, 270, you're already looking at, actually, that's off. 270, 270, that's for... it's 14. That actually is supposed to be 540. 540. So that's not right, but whatever. And that's also roughly. I mean, who knows? Alright, boys and girls, let's continue now that we have over almost 1,300 miles to our trip. That's what we can do. What time is it? It's actually just about to hit 10 o'clock p.m. And we have just a little bit of, a little bit of time left. Alright, let's get going here. We're just gonna keep it in one for now because there was no point because the light was red. Alright, but now since it's green. You know, to tell you the truth, it's sometimes so scary to, Yeah, Jesus Christ, $1,400. Oh, they have to make these lights a little better. The yellow looks like green, and you get screwed in the end. The last time was $700. Now this is 14. So they doubled the fine. Jesus Christ. I pretty much lost, almost, 14, 7, nearly $2,300 in fines alone. That's just ridiculous, guys. Is that going to put us to 65? Yes, we are out of state lines, boys and girls. So, which means we are free to do 55. 55, stay alive. That is what we're doing. But yep, it's, you know, it's getting closer to summer, guys. Now we're going back down to 40 here. I don't understand why. And I also got to keep a lookout for railroad tracks. I was watching one of my streamers on YouTube. He was driving down a road like this. And I don't know if he wasn't paying attention or what, but what happened was he came across a set of railroad tracks, right? Do we make a left up here? No, we go straight. I don't know if he was not paying attention or what, but he did something. Well, not did something, but anyways, by the time he realized that the arms were coming down and a train was coming, he could not stop. So, he could not stop in time. So that's the only thing that I really gotta pay attention to, is these railroad crossings. Until I know where they are located and I remember them, then course, and it's a different story because I will know where they are, so I can know when it starts slowing down. But when you're just going down the street doing, you know, the old double nickel, you know. But once again, that's you have to pay attention, you know. You have to keep your eyes on the road at all times, you know. You know what they taught you in CDL school, you know, check your mirrors. No more than 5 seconds, even though I think that's too much, but actually I think it's check your mirrors every 5 seconds. I think that's what it is. And then leave your eyes on the mirror for 1 second. Unless, of course, you're turning or trying to merge, then you'll want to fix yourself on that mirror for as long as possible. So you can keep an eye on any cars. But that was just a meteor. Oh my God. That was a little crazy. That looked like a meteor. So, all right. Oh, come on. Oh, let's see if we can stop. Who? All right. That's a little crazy. He just like, you know what? Screw this cop. I'm going. That's pretty much what he said. He's like, screw this cop. I'm going. I always miss that, and I don't like it. I always miss that turn. Not that turn, but trying to get into and stay in this lane. I know it's impossible. But I try. Now, if I'm not mistaken, I should not have to weigh in again. But we'll see. Jeez, that was a loud yawn. I promise you guys that was not for me. I can tell you that now. Well, I guess what we should do is maybe do an up. No, I think we are actually pretty close. We actually should be damn near there. Tell you the truth, guys. Oh, that was a cop. Luckily, I was didn't even hit 55 yet. Oh, and was supposed to turn off. Yep, we're here. I thought we were here. Pretty much. Alright. Alright. Got no one to the right. We got an ambulance going. I think we're good to go here. Alright. Yeah, that's a loud yawn. Don't even Jesus Christ think about it. That was a little scary. Yeah, anyways, we're still in the beta stages. I'm probably going to transfer back once we complete this trip. And then see if anything, if they released this version yet. But of course, we will see. Yes, that is what we're going to do. If Eric can just, you know, stay in the left-hand lane. Right-hand lane, left-hand lane. Oh my god, I'm gonna kill everybody if I stay in the left-hand lane. Alright, they changed the street light to green, because they knew I was coming. And now this is gonna be interesting, because something tells me they're gonna want it in that corner. And that's the one thing I don't like about this rail export, is that they want it constantly in that one corner. Always. So you have to pull in forward and then back it in, and it's sometimes ridiculous. All right, hit first gear. I know that car was pulling, but I can't see past. We should be good. So I'm gonna show you here what I mean. I done this a while ago, and I haven't brought anything back here, bang to a rail export for a while, because I was pretty much carrying hazardous stuff. So they want it around that bend. That is where they want it. So what we're gonna have to do is line ourselves up. Alright, see if we can, and then hopefully get ourselves good enough. I have to lock up the wheel so I can turn. Alright, because I was not going to make it with that trailer beam right there. I would not have made it. See how long it takes for you to correct. So you definitely have to take your time, because it can take It takes the trailer so long to correct itself. I might have to do this in third person, because I always have troubles doing this. Alright, I know. Now I gotta correct it so I'm not totally crazy. I should have started turning. Not what I wanted. Lock up the trailer brakes a little bit. Alright. See if I can get this straight. Alright. Alright, come on. I know I can do this. I did this once. I think I did this once, but it wasn't recording. I know that. I think I was just doing it on my own free will. Recording off camera. Truck likes to slide to the right. Let's see if we can get this time. See, now I have to now pivot it around this corner. So you pretty much have two corners that you have to go around. And some people, they can do it right where I was. Stall the truck, guys. Right where I was. And I did it once. Messed up just a little bit. Nope, to the left. All right, to the left. One back this time. Woo. One hump this time. Alright. There you go. Almost. I stalled the truck again. Come on. All right. That's not what I wanted. Thank you. Come on. Try not. Alright. Should be fine now. It's the wrong way. Jesus. That was loud. Alright, now this is just getting ridiculous now. Alright, we can do this. We can do this. Yeah, no, it's not gonna happen. As I was saying, guys, they really stick you on this one. They really do. So this is the hardest part. It's trying to get it in here. And sometimes you have to lock up the tractor wheels and pivot it in. Sometimes you have to. Alright. Just back it in. I think that's good. We'll see. Excellent. Yes. Distance 549 miles. Time taken 13 hours 14 minutes. Fuel consumed is 117.5 gallons. Base reward 549 miles. So that was 10,119. Level 13. Bonus was an extra 1,000, and then rank 2 for long distance was 981, and then fragile cargo bonus was another 1,000. So we're doing there, girls, boys and girls, and we leveled up to workhorse. That is how we're doing it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do a long distance, make everything even Steven. And that is what I'm gonna do. I know there's supposed to be a sleeping pad right there. So until next time, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I surely do. I always enjoy American Truck Simulator and doing it for you guys. So if you enjoyed this video, guys, hit that like button. If you're new to my channel, guys, subscribe, and then you'll be able to know when I post videos and all that good stuff. And then once again, guys, I do apologize if the game volume or if my voice is louder than you're normally used to. But I do hope it's better than the previous videos that I have done. So till next time, guys, I will talk to you later. Bye.